Okay, so today we are going to do I Want to Be Adored by the Stone Roses. I have tried to listen to the Stone Roses before, but the video was taken down, and I can't remember if I did this. This was many months ago, but we're going to see if this goes up and is not taken down. So anyway, Stone Roses, I Want to Be Adored. Apparently it's a popular song, and I know this band is very popular in the UK. So anyway, let's just go. That's nice. Love the soft vocals.
I wanna
All right, so I want to be adored by the Stone Roses. So I want to say at the start, I said there during the song, but I really liked the soft vocals, and also, what came to mind was I know that Oasis was very much influenced by the Stone Roses, and I was just kind of looking, my eyes bothering me, but I was just kind of looking for like similarities, and this really reminded me of the start of the song. It's not the same at all, but it really reminded me of Columbia by Oasis, and I don't know, it just that's what that song popped out of me. And then also his vocals, it really reminded me of Billy Corgan from the Smashing Pumpkins, and this band had was out before both of those bands, but so obviously, yeah, I can hear influence, and it's just, yeah, soft vocals just really remind me of Corgan. And yeah, I know Noel Gallagher really likes the Stone Roses, and yeah, I can see how they were so influential and on British music especially. So yeah, we're gonna get into the bio of the song here from genius.com. So a lucid album opener spearheaded by the hushed ringing vocal of Ian Brown. Yes, Ian Brown, that is the lead singer, repeating selected lines of lyrics throughout the entire song. The song is a mea culpa to fans of the band who criticized the band for signing to a major label, with Ian Brown effectively claiming that the group did so in order to reach a wider audience via the resources of this new label. So, all right, yeah, okay, I can see. I mean, I don't really like. Yeah, why would you not want them? I mean, I guess, you know, it's just like, oh, they're doing it on their own or whatever. They're not on a major label. But I mean, you want to be on a major label at some point, I would think. And yeah, they're doing it if they just wanted to reach a wider audience. I mean, that sounds like a good reason to try and get more people to like you. So anyway, it says for the credits of the song, written by John Squire and Ian Brown, vocals Ian Brown, guitar John Squire, engineer Paul Schroeder, backing vocals Alan Wren, drums Alan Wren, and bass Gary Mountfield. And I also noticed the bass at the start of the song. That was nice as well. Just a nice, pretty song, I thought. I thought it was very pretty. That's a good word for it. And yeah, so I guess I'll get into some annotations now of the song. So with the first verse, I don't have to sell my soul, he's already in me. I don't need to sell my soul, he's already in me. So it says, like Patti Smith's Gloria, this starts the album off with a huge theological claim. The conception of original sin suggests that man is born in evil, or man is born evil and must choose goodness. The devil is already within, hence he has no need to sell his soul. And the lyricism here is also very well done. With the chorus, I want to be adored, I want to be adored. Like I said, I really love his delivery here. Furthering the religious theme set out in the selling of souls, the adoration is no longer reserved for God alone. This is what the evil needs for self-adoration. So I guess, yeah, the evil needs self-adoration. All right. So the first verse says again, and then we have the chorus again, and then we have another chorus, adored, I want to be adored. And yeah, I think it would be the same thing there. Yep, more religious themes. And then the second verse here, you adore me, you adore me, you adore me. I wanna be adored. And then we go on to the third verse, I wanna be adored. And we'll see if there's anything there. Nope, same thing for that. So yeah, like the about of the song said, he Ian Brown basically says the same lines over and over, which I didn't even really catch on to. I just was, you know, in a trance with his voice. But yeah, so that's all the annotations there in the bio for the song. And like I said, I know that this band influenced many other bands, especially around Manchester. And this was released in 1989. So I guess, I mean, I'm thinking of the Smiths. So they were done in 87. So yeah, they came out 89 here with this. So yeah, I don't know. I'm just thinking in my head. But yeah, the Stone Roses, like I said, I tried to react to them before, and the video was taken down, so hopefully this video stays up. And yeah, I really like the song, I love the vocals, and thank you for the suggestion. And also thanks for watching, thanks for liking, subscribing, and commenting, and all that kind of thing. Getting close to 600 subscribers, which is pretty crazy, which isn't a lot to some people, but you know, just for me in my bedroom doing this, 600 people subscribed, that's pretty nice. So anyway, Yeah, thanks again, and I guess I'll talk to you guys again soon, and be safe and all that kind of a thing. All right.